It's left me weak. I won't last long. Help! The flames! They... You released me! Oh, long have I waited for this moment!
A dry, rattling laugh rises from the figure's ancient gullet.
This was a reward for doing my duty, for fulfilling the wishes of one Brachus Rex. Do you know that name?
The figure nods grimly.
He did terrible things while trying to master Source, bend it to his will. I had a part in this, I must admit. Perhaps I deserve the flames. No, I was a scholar, a librarian. Brachus sought the secrets of Source, but he had no patience for sifting through ancient scrolls and tablets. I unearthed knowledge of a great power within those texts, a great and terrible power, one that Brachus coveted above all.
The figure slowly shakes his head.
I will not say. I spoke of it once and was damned to eternal hellfire for it. Were I to speak of it again, I could damn the whole world. Brachus must have failed. Had he not, the world as you know it would be gone. What I learned of could still be out there. I will not speak of it. I won't risk having another Brachus discovering it. Through violence? Oh, I've already suffered more than any would think. Good! Were I to say any more, I'd only put you in danger. Leave this awful place. Go live. And stranger, thank you for...
Frozen ground in the middle of a swamp. What's going on?
Thank you.
Frozen ground in the middle of a swamp. What's going on? A winter dragon. What on earth is it doing chained up here?
Unreadable glyphs mantle this ancient pillar. Braided through thick iron rings, source-infused chains bind the dragon tightly. The dragon stares you down with flinty, intelligent eyes. He tries to speak, but his jaw is bound tightly by the same thick chains that shackle him to the pillars. The dragon rakes the earth with icy claws. Quakes from the impact knock you back. The freed dragon looks sick and pale. As you approach, he stretches his tattered wings weakly and fixes his intense gaze upon you. Frozen tears glint in his eyes.
My gratitude for your efforts, friend. Yet I am no more free now than I was in those chains. Please. Help me find true liberty, or sing me to the endless slumber. But of course, that must be why you stand before me. Slain called to the Lord of Death, and here you are. A coincidence. Ah. My fate, it seems, is not my own to call. My soul is bound to joyless obedience. Purged of my source by the wickedest of witches, I stand enthralled to her every whim. She has only to command, and my traitorous body complies. The witch Rudecca. I was in love with her once. For the smallest slight, really a trifle, she wielded a purging wand against me, enslaving me to her will. Now only my voice remains my own. She trekked far underground beneath a nearby tower, seeking ingredients for her vile potions. I can feel her dark heart beating within my own, even from here. I await her return, yet I would prefer to welcome death in the sight of her face again. Allow? I did not choose this. As I am quite sure, you did not choose any number of indignities in your own life. Least of all your presence on this hellish isle.
The dragon sniffs and rakes at the ground with one razor-sharp talon.
A thought cannot mend a soul. A prayer cannot heal what has been ruined. You talk to soothe yourself, not me. That you would even ask such a question of a stranger already in your debt. There is much goodness within you, but this task would not be easy. Rudecca is a canny one, cat to your mouse. She consumed all my source with her purging wand. So long as she holds it, she has absolute control over me. If you could retrieve it for me, I could be free again. You would have my gratitude, and whatever aid I can then offer to you.
as this. It looks strange. I'm not picking that up. I could try moving it. What is this place?
Perfect. Little bones and bloody mush. The perfect soil for blood roses. Yes, this will do. Little bones and bloody mush.